can't buy. It resides between my eyes. Walked through the fire, came out better on the other side. See, life's like a beach if you find the sand. And right now, I'm feeling like $100,000.
You are listening to Inspired Insider with your host, Dr. Jeremy Weisz.
Live from the Sweet Snack Show. Dr. Jeremy Weisz here, live at the Sweet Snack Show. I'm here with the founder of PodiPop, Elan, and tell us about the product. Tell us about the products you have.
Yeah, so PodiPop is a South Indian-inspired popcorn company. So we use a multicolored heirloom popcorn kernel, allowing for better digestion and a more nutrient-dense product. And then we coat that with some coconut oil and a South Indian lentil-based seasoning. So,
delicious.
Yeah, it is. And so that allows us to reach 5 grams of protein per serving. The product's all organic, gluten-free, vegan, non-GMO. It'll be kosher certified by the time it goes into production. And then, so we use a base of five lentil powders, and then we mix that with three different seasonings. So we do a sweet, savory, and spicy. The savory is the original one. That's more cumin, salt, and pepper, kind of a traditional savory flavor for South India. Then we do a sweet, which is cinnamon sugar, and then a spicy one with just some mild Indian chilies.
So how did you come up with the idea?
So it's really my wife's idea. I'm the co-founder and co-creator. I'm just the executor, I guess. My wife and I, when we were dating, she would make this PodiPop. And so she had done her yoga training in India, and her teacher's mom makes this. And so Podi is a very interesting seasoning in South India. It's kind of like a marinara sauce for an Italian family. It's passed down from family to, you know, generation to generation. So she starts making it for me, and I'm like, oh, this is really good. We should do a business. Huh? And the next time, I'm like, no, we should really do a business. And then finally, like 6 months later, I'm like, okay, we're going to do a business around this. No one's doing this. It's unique. We could do like multiple flavors, and we could correspond the seasonings with the chakras and all this stuff, and started thinking about like a mission-driven business that we could create, and ended up getting into Amazon consulting and started a food podcast so I could launch this. And then the business just kind of took the back seat for 2.5 years. And I watched an episode of Shark Tank recently, and I was like, you know, if this woman got a deal.
Which
for like
one inspired you?
I think it was this girl that got almost $1 million deal for an oatmeal pop-up store or something. And I was like, I love oatmeal, but really? Like, there's so much innovation possible in the popcorn space. You know, everyone's coming into popcorn today. Sea salt.
Why is that?
You know, you buy in weight and you sell in volume, first of all, so it's high margin. And then, you know, it's ready to go, ready to eat on the go snack. And the market's just booming. It's gone from like 8 to 12 billion. It's expected to go to a $20 billion industry by 2023. And I just think there's so much opportunity, but there's a lack of innovation. A lot of people are coming in, you know, specifically at the show, there's a lot of caramel corn and white cheddar and sea salt and kettle corn, the traditional flavors. And we thought we'd bring something innovative and unique and worldly to the American palate.
So talk about the evolution of the production. So it starts in your kitchen. Where does it go from there?
Well, it started in our kitchen, and it goes to the shelf right here. we're here to do a couple of things. Number one is get product validation. So we want to know, is this product a mass appeal? Do we move forward with it? That's why we're here. We put together the business in under 4.5 months, and we're here. So we're pretty excited about that. The other thing is...
Yeah, so what do you do in that 4.5 months? This is fascinating.
I call as many people as I know to learn as much as I can. My food podcast gave me a deep insight into the industry, and so it was so funny. I swear every guest I had on the show, whether it was Nick Ingersoll from Barnana or Diana Trout from Health Aid Kombucha, everyone in between, I think the one thing they always said was, if I knew then what I know now, I would have never done it. So stupid me thinking, oh, well, I know all of their bad experiences and learning curves. I'm just going to jump right into it. So I've been grateful to really have a equity partner on board who's guided me along the way. But really it was design, product refining, playing with the recipe at home in our kettle popper, and, you know, just trying to figure out where I begin in terms of production. And making the decisions was the hardest part. Do I go into a production run for the show? Oh, minimum order quantities are really high, but if I do a low one, it's going to cost me $30,000. And so trying to navigate all that, and I said, I'll just do it here. Let me get here, and I'll find distributors, I'll find brokers, I'll find co-packers, manufacturers, and I found a lot of that here. And
So the minimum viable product, literally.
Exactly. MVP is what we have today.
So what has been some of the response? What's the feedback you're getting?
Yeah, so a lot of people are definitely saying the branding is on point. They love the packaging, the logo.
I didn't know what Podi, that it meant that.
No one does. Yeah and that's again, some of the feedback is some of the bigger chains were talking about how we can make the call-outs on the packaging a little bit better. And, you know,
like to explain what Podi is? Or?
Podi is, yeah. And so these pictures right here, some of them are stock.
Yeah, you have that here.
It doesn't really give a deep insight as to what Podi is. People think it's PodiPop or Podi, you know. So there's a learning curve there that doesn't throw us off. But the call-outs, I think we can do a better job on. And, you know, we use a multicolored heirloom kernel, like I said. Why? Right? Does that go on the back? Does it go on the front? A lot of these things that when you're starting a brand and packaging and retail, I have a lot of background in digital marketing and Amazon. And so what you can promote through pictures and title and features there is a lot different than when you have a 3-second opportunity on a store shelf.
Right,
totally. Yeah.
What other feedback are you getting about the product?
People really like it. And, you know, we ended up pulling the spicy one because they gave us samples from India. We have the product, the seasoning made in India right now. And so they sent us like 12 different varieties, and we're like, that's good for sweet, that's good for spicy. We love the savory one originally. And what we ordered for the sample for spicy didn't come back on the batch. And so when I opened the bag, it wasn't as bright orange, and I said, oh crap. So we got some response that, oh, what, that's spicy? And so we pulled it for the second day. And
because of the look?
No, because of the spice.
Oh.
It didn't have, I could tell it didn't have enough chili in it. And so, you know, you go to some of the popcorn, or even in the next door to us, the bacon guys, they have a habanero, and people like that.
I mean,
real
kick.
That's a serious heat, yeah. And so we really going for like a middle of the road. It doesn't burn your mouth if you eat.
It's an American spicy. When I go spicy, it's like I want a light spice.
Yeah, exactly. You want to take a few bites and be like, oh, that kicks me.
Yeah.
You know, you don't want to, oh my God, I need a drink of water. Yeah. So yeah, product feedback's been really good. There's some grocers that are interested in it. I think our ideal channels are the healthy grocers. A lot of corporate gift companies are interested because it's unique, it's innovative. It
right.
You know, checks all the boxes with the organic, vegan, all that stuff. Yeah.
So what's next?
What's
after
next?
The show?
Yeah. It's a great question. Big decisions. You know, how do I?
We're gonna talk in a year and see what happens, right?
We'll be here next year. I think what'll happen is I got to go on a plane ride to India and really solidify the recipe. That's most important. Packaging, I know we'll need some refining, but I can get to that. I think some of the discount chain stores that are interested in the grocery, and you know, they can help us navigate that space a little bit on the costing. I've got manufacturing lined up if we want it. I think one of the big decisions is convenience stores have been really interested in the product, but they don't want a grocery bag. They don't want a 4.4 or 4.5 ounce. They want that 1.2, 1.3 ounce single serve. Yeah. And so, you know, when you're launching three flavors, and then two sizes, that's six SKUs, minimum order quantity per flavor, per size, you know, you start talking about a big run.
Right.
And so we have to talk about where we want to manufacture, how we want to manufacture, if we want to manufacture. You know, one of my partners is saying, you know, maybe we take the orders from those companies that want to place them and match that with that minimum order quantity. And so it's a flush, you know, and spend the rest of the energy really promoting and marketing. So got a lot of big decisions, but it's been great to get the feedback, you know. Up until now, it's been friends and family, and as much as you'd want to trust them that they're giving honest feedback,
they're not paying,
and right. Neither are these people, and so you don't really ever get feedback until it's on the shelf, right?
Yeah.
So
where should we point people towards? Where should they go?
Yeah, so our website will be up shortly. It's podipop.com, and Instagram is podipopcorn.com, just podipopcorn on Instagram. And come check us out or send me an email at elan@soulpoppingfoods.com if you have any questions. That's soul, S-O-U-L, poppingfoods.com.
All right. Thanks, Elan. Awesome.
What I got, you can't buy. It resides between my eyes. Walked through the fire, came out better on the other side. See, life's like a beach if you find the sand. And right now, I'm feeling like 100 grand.